Joe McKay again. Hi there, this is Joe McKay again. This time at the base camp of Aconcagua at 14,500 feet.
I like to prepare some rescue coils, extra rope that will be used only in a case of emergency. I lap coil the rope and then quickly put a couple of wraps, put the byte of rope through and flip it over. I can stick that in my pack. A couple of meters of rope and I do the fisherman's on a byte tie-in. Okay, if I'm traveling with two on the rope, and my partner is a lot bigger than I, I'm gonna need some help to slow him down, or if a mate, so I will tie some friction knots in the rope. Merely figure eights, or overhand knots, every 60 centimeters to meter apart. These knots are designed to cut into the edge of the crevasse. They're also, if you fall in a crevasse, give you points to hang on to and aid, pull yourself out.
I tell you, just because you're out in the wilderness doesn't mean you have to be, you know, uncivilized.
On rope four, it's good. Three, it's good. Two, I get nervous again because there's chances that I could fall in a crevasse on a downslope or walking down a hill. I fall in a crevasse. I know it's going to be really hard for them to stop me, and when I'm guiding myself, those are the situations where I have knots tied in the rope between me and the person, so that if somebody goes in, the rope cuts into the lip, that knot gets sucked into the snow and acts like a beautiful stopper. It's really secure. It's a real peace of mind giver when you only have two people on a rope and you're traveling on a big glacier. A good